a giant.
8 YCR, the power station. John, you're on the air live with Paul and Gene from KISS.
Hi.
How are you?
My question is, how'd you guys get the idea for the makeup, and why did you stop wearing it?
Good question. Well, we got the idea basically because at the time the band got together, most bands really thought that they were doing the audience a favor just showing up, and some of them showed up looking like they just rolled out of bed after not taking a bath for a week. And we just decided, let's give the audience the kind of show that we wanted to see. So we wanted to be something special. And, you know, we just started doing big shows, kind of things that nobody was doing at that point. And some bands were saying, ah, that's not music and that's not what it's all about. But guess what? Every one of those bands wound up doing a big show. And once an audience sees what's, you know, what's possible and what somebody could give them, then they expect it from everybody. So hopefully it worked out for everybody because I don't think an audience at this point will accept the kind of crap that people were doing back then.
Yeah. Thanks for the call, John. Next up is Mary Catherine, listening to Y102 in Montgomery, Alabama. You're on the hit line with KISS, Mary.
Y'all are so cool. How have you stayed popular for so long?
That probably has to do more with you than with us. You know, we try to do, we do what we love to do, which is to rock. We put on the kind of shows that we like to see, which is the bigger the better, the more bombastic, the better. And probably the real answer to that has to do with you people.
I mean, we love what we're doing, but obviously we feed off our audiences. We like coming on shows like this. We like getting a chance to talk to everybody. When we're on the street, we like our fans to come over. I think the only way to stay really in touch and make music that people can relate to is to stay in touch with the people. Once you lose contact with people, if success means cutting yourself off from your roots, then you're not going to be making rock and roll music, because rock and roll music is music that people make who walk and talk and do the same kind of things that you and I do.
Thanks for your call, Mary Catherine. Listening to 93 Zoo FM in Spokane, Dallas, you're on Live with KISS.
Hey.
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 I have a question for you, Gene.
Yeah.
I was wondering, is it really true about you and all those women?
Yeah.
What?
Yes.
Okay. Was that the extent of that?
Well, you know, the thing is, it's interesting that when you're in a rock and roll band, people tend to get really fascinated with the same kind of stuff that goes on in everyday life with everybody else, only for some reason they want to get a thrill through what you're doing. I don't think that anything different goes on in rock and roll than any place else. I think to really, like, dwell on it is, like, to take the emphasis off the music. I mean, there's no mysteries. There's nothing going on here that doesn't go on in your town behind the same closed doors.
Inquiring minds want to know. Dallas wanted to know, and he got his answer. Thanks for calling, Dallas. We're just getting cranked up tonight. Gene and Paul from KISS are with us live, and we're just 2 minutes away from more calls, so stay with us.
Pumping the stars out all over the place. This is the one and only Hitline USA. We're live on the satellite this last Sunday in April. My name is Elvis Duran from Z100 in New York.
And I'm Brenda Ross from Power 106 in Hollywood. Tonight we're hanging with one half of KISS. Gene Simmons and Paul Stanley are here with us live.
And the rest of our friends are back in Texas waiting for us to get there tomorrow morning for the
start
of the
tour. Lubbock already.
That's right.
And
later this hour, Michelangelo from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. He'll be right here. But right now, we're taking calls for the guys from KISS.
Absolutely. Next up is Jennifer in New York City checking us out tonight on Z100. Go ahead, Jennifer.
Gene, Pat,
yeah.
I really love you guys. I've grown up on you.
Awesome.
My question is, what's the favorite song that you've ever done?
Boy, it's tough.
That's a tough one. You're talking about 23 records.
23 records. Is...
What's Paul probably has a different favorite song than I do, but our favorite songs don't always revolve around who writes it. Paul, what's your favorite song?
Well, let me see. What's my favorite
song? We're putting on our DJ
voices. I don't know.
Voices.
Well, I don't know.
Well, probably today it's Forever, since that was a big hit for us, and probably tomorrow it's going to be Rise to It, which is going to be our next single.
I don't know. Love Gun, Detroit Rock City, probably one of those two.
Yeah, I like Love Gun.
Yeah. I like Detroit Rock City.
Okay, we have a split.
We have a split.
Here.
All
we're
right,
going to
we'll
play them both at the same time.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thanks for your call, Jennifer.
Thanks.
In B104 land, Baltimore, Bonnie, you're on with the guys from KISS.
Hi, guys. How you doing?
Hey, Bonnie. How
Hi.
You doing?
Hi. I just have a quick question. Do you have any idea about how many albums you've sold over the years?
Mm. Well, it's a wild question because nobody likes to brag, but everybody's proud of what they do. The last count we heard was something around I think it was around 50 million.
Whoa. That's incredible.
We don't actually ever get to find out, really. You know, we're always usually too busy writing songs, touring, whatever, but we get all kinds of figures thrown in our faces.
Yeah.
We actually find out this stuff by reading an interview. You know, somebody, Kiss, 23 albums and 75 million records later. And so, you know, we turn around to each other. Did we do that?
It's funny, because then I go into my garage, and I can only count 30 million that I have stacked up there.
Yeah, so. A big garage. Thanks for calling in tonight, Bunny. We're about to play your first hit record ever from back in 1975.
Boy.
From 76 to 79, you guys were voted the most popular band in the world over groups like the Beatles and Led Zeppelin. That's astonishing.
Who?
The Beatles and Led Zeppelin.
Pretty good company.
Have you ever tried to figure out your popularity?
No. I think that the best way to do something is do what you do naturally, and it'll find, you know, what do they say, water finds its own mark or whatever. You just do what you do, and hopefully it finds an audience. When you try to second guess what you're doing, I think you're not being honest. Either people are going to like who you are or they're not. We're proud of the people who like us, and we're real proud of the people who don't.
All right. Here's the anthem that started it all. Turn your box to 10, because Kiss is on Hitline USA.
Hitline USA, that's Kiss with a song you know is going to be in their set when they hit the road later on in the week. That's Rock and Roll All Night. Let's run down a few of those upcoming tour dates. They could be coming to your town real soon. On Friday, the whole tour opens in Lubbock, Texas. Saturday, Dallas. And then Sunday, Kiss takes over Austin, Texas.
May 9th, it's Wichita, Kansas. The 10th, Omaha. The 11th, Sioux Falls, South Dakota. We're going to give you some more dates in a bit. Up next, it's Back to Calls, and we'll get a double shot of Kiss on after this from Pepsi.
First, the Battle of the New Songs, weeknights at 7:40 on KISS 98.5.
Zapped directly into only the coolest of radios. Live via satellite, you're listening to the one and only Hitline USA. I'm Elvis Duran, along with Brenda Ross and our very special guest, Paul Stanley, Gene Simmons from KISS.
Later on, Michelangelo, one of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles from Down in the Sewer, is going to call in on our Hit Blast of the Week. Right now, we're taking calls for and rolling hits from KISS.
1-800-53-PEPSI, that's the toll-free number. Harold, punched up from Biloxi, where he's listening to 93.7 WQID. Go ahead, Harold, you're on with Kiss.
Hi, myself and Def Jeff just want to know, when Kiss goes in to record a record, do they do it as a group or like as a single person?
Oh, there's no single... Good question. There's no single person. It's kind of like an octopus. There's like tons of legs, tons of arms. The more people in the studio, the better. I mean, we'd rather just plug into the amps and crank them. That's usually the best way to start. What you build on it after that is really up to you, but you got to keep that human element.
Do you guys have any, like, idiosyncrasies about recording? Like, do you like particular kinds of studios?
We will not record without electricity.
Is that right?
Yeah, that's about it. But, I mean, we record everywhere. The first record was recorded in New York City in a place called Bell Sound, which doesn't exist anymore.
We'll basically go anywhere.
Anywhere.
It doesn't matter.
And do you have a preference as to time of the day or, you know?
No, because there's no windows in a studio.
No.
We don't want clocks. We don't want anything to let us know what time it is, whether it's day, night. We usually work until we collapse, and that's about it.
Okay, fine. Next up is Teresa, listening to Q101 in Chicago tonight. Go ahead, Teresa.
Hi, guys.
Hi, Teresa.
Hi, Teresa.
I just wanted to ask you about that movie you made, Phantom in the Park. I thought that was the coolest movie.
It also won 10 Academy Awards. Did you know that? Yes.
Will you plan on making any more movies?
Not like that.
Not like that?
No, that was a real interesting film. I mean, it turned out totally different than we expected it to, but one of the great things about being in this band is how many different things we've gotten a chance to do. You know, you always want to do something special for the fans. You want to try to give them something extra. It's like this time when we're going out on tour, we didn't want to just do a huge show. We wanted to get some great bands to go with us. So we've got Slaughter with us, and we've got Faster Pussycat. So it's like we try to do something special. So this show is like a big night of rock and roll. It's more than you could possibly take, but you will take it and enjoy it.
There you go. Thanks for your call, Teresa. Listening to Hitline in Sacramento, California. FM 102, as a matter of fact. Aaron, you're on live with the guys from KISS.
Hi, Gene and Paul.
Hiya.
First of all, I'd like to say I'm 21 years old right now, and I first saw you guys in the Paul Lynn show.
Wow.
Wow.
And
as a Halloween special.
Five,
right. I was in first grade then, and I've loved you guys ever since. I think you're great.
That's great.
My question is, if you guys weren't in rock and roll right now,
What would you do?
What would you be doing?
I guess the answer would be, this is Gene. I guess if I couldn't get up on stage, I guess the second best job would probably be getting as close as possible to the stage. Maybe I'd be a roadie, just to get out there and feel that excitement, because when a band hits the stage, I mean, I feel that way anyway. It's as close as I can see. I mean, it's got to be as close to godliness as you can get, that excitement. It's almost like electric church, you know, when a performer gets up on stage, what happens between the performer and the audience. So I guess I'd be a roadie.
I don't, it's so weird for me to think about it, because ever since I was 6 years old, I wanted to be a rock and roller. I wanted to play music. So I don't know anything else. You know, it's kind of like somebody say, well, if you were an animal, what animal would you want to be? It's as weird to me as that, because this is what I've always wanted to do. So I don't know.
On the other hand, Paul makes very good salads.
Does he now?
Very good ones.
Mm.
Whatever that has to do with anything, that went right over my head.
If you could be a salad,
yes,
a Caesar or a Caesar salad.
Thanks for the call, Aaron. We're going to send you a CD copy of Kiss's new Hot in the Shade album, thanks to Kiss and the folks over at Mercury Records. Right now, we're going to kick off a double shot of Kiss, first up from 14 years ago. Here's Beth on Hitline USA.
Hitline USA, that's Kiss, and their very first single off their latest album, Hot in the Shade. That's Hide Your Heart, wrapping up a double shot of Kiss. Next up, we'll get back to the calls. Rocketing out all over the universe, live from all over the place. This is Hitline USA. I'm Elvis Duran in New York City.
And I'm Brenda Ross in Hollywood. Tonight, when you dial up the Hitline at 1-800-53-PEPSI, you could go one-on-one with Gene and Paul from KISS. They kick off their world tour this coming Friday night, and on May 12th, they'll be just outside of Kansas City at the Sandstone Amphitheater. On the 15th, it's on to Saginaw, Michigan, and May 16th, the Sports Arena in Toledo.
Some other big KISS concert dates include June 1st in St. Louis, June 2nd in Chicago, June 8th in Indianapolis, June 26th in Philly, and June 28th right across the Hudson from where I'm sitting right now. KISS takes over the Meadowlands Arena over in New Jersey. Keep it right here on this station for more news on the 1990 KISS tour.
All right, we're about to roll out a KISS classic, but first we're going to go to San Francisco where Greg is standing by listening in on X100. Go ahead, Greg.
Hi, Gene.
Hi, Greg.
How are you doing today?
Okay.
That's great. Hey, listen, I know that you guys are against drugs and all. Can you tell me how come so many rock groups are drawn to drugs?
I think everybody has to figure out for themselves how they want to lead their lives, and I don't want to preach to anybody, you included. I think you got to figure it out for yourself. So, you know, it's just my choice. My choice for me. You figure it out.
Thanks for your call, Greg. Listening to Y100 in Miami. Kelly, you're on the Hitline.
I was going to say, I really like you. And do you remember one concert better than any other?
I'm sorry?
What do you remember one concert better than any other?
You know, when you're doing as many as we're doing, this tour is going to take in at least, from last count, about 115 cities. So every one of them is really special for some reason or another. They're always great. I mean, I'm not trying to be a diplomat. Obviously, there's certain places you remember for one or two different reasons. Some of them, when you're when we play Meadowlands, for us, that's real special, or when we're in the New York area. But L.A.'s also special, and we've had great times in Texas. So once you start that, you go, well, wait a minute, what about Kiel Auditorium? And then you think, well, Detroit's great. So it's all great.
All right, thanks for the call, Kelly. Next up is Justine, listening to Z93 in Dayton, Ohio. Go ahead, Justine.
Hi, how you doing?
Great, how you doing?
Fine. You guys have been doing this for quite a long time, and you've been doing it successfully, might I add. How much longer do you plan on doing it successfully?
Well, we can't say how long we're going to do it successfully. We do it because we love doing it. When it's no longer successful, maybe we'll have to look at each other and wonder why. If people aren't getting off on it, it's probably going to affect us. If we're not having a great time, probably our fans aren't going to have a great time. And it works the other way. If the fans aren't having a great time, it's not going to be quite as much fun for us. So right now, everything seems to be running real smoothly. And as long as that's happening, we won't even have to think about, you know, the question. Sometimes people say to you, boy, it's going so great, or you've been doing this so long, how long are you going to do it? It's not really something we ever think about. When it's over or when we think it's time to leave, we'll do it.
I think we hardly ever say it to each other because it's something you just sense. But probably the simple answer to that, as long as it feels good, as long as we're having a good time, we'll keep doing it because to be up on stage and fooling people. Some of the groups that have come out recently, unfortunately, I think have been doing it more as a job. For us, this is more, you know, a love. And as soon as the love is gone, you should stop doing it.
Thank you very much, Justine. Great question. Let's get some more Kiss cranking out here. Gene Simmons wrote this. It's off the Kiss Double Platinum CD. This is Calling Dr. Love on Hitline USA.
That's Kiss on Hitline USA with Calling Dr. Love.
Ooh.
Gene, do you think you can get me his phone number?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
except the song says, I'm the doctor of love.
Uh-oh. I'm looking at him right now.
Yes, you are.
Oh, my God. Stand
He's
by.
He's a dentist.
We're coming back with Forever.
Okay, so on time here.
The Rocky Allen Showgram gets you up Monday through Friday, 6 to 10 a.m. on Kiss 98.5.
Lock it in right now. This is The Hit Line. I'm Brenda Ross along with Elvis Duran, and tonight we're hanging out with Paul and Gene from Kiss.
They're scattered.
Next week it's Technotronic and a lot of Miles. In 2 weeks, Sam Kinison will be here. In 3 weeks, Billy Idol joins The Hit Line.
Yeah.
But right now in Knoxville, Candy is on hold for Kiss. She's listening to I-100 cranked up real loud. Go ahead, Candy, you're on.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Candy.
I'm a big fan of yours.
Oh, great.
I was wondering, do you guys ever think of the influence Kiss has on other bands?
Well, I think, I mean, it's kind of obvious to us, and I guess it's kind of obvious to other people. We don't really dwell on it that much, but I think everybody's aware of it, and we're really, I mean, we're proud of it. I think the only funny thing is when you have some bands where it's really obvious, and for some reason they deny it, or when they're on their way up, they talk about how they, you know, basically copied everything you did, and then when they suddenly make it, they can't remember how to spell your name. But everybody knows what it's all about, and we're real pleased. You know, we were influenced by other bands, and it's great to know that we're still around and we're influencing other bands. I think it's great.
All right, next up is Rick in Providence, listening to 92 Pro FM. You're on The Hit Line with Kiss.
How you doing?
Okay, great. How are you?
All right. Hey, I just wanted to mention that 19 years, I've only been to one concert, and it was Kiss in 1978. I had a great time.
That's
fond memory.
You've only been to one concert?
One concert, but I intend on going back when you come to Providence.
This is the one to see, guy. We're going to be playing for about 2.5 hours, and it's the biggest show we've done since the one you saw.
I believe it. Hey, my question is, when you assembled Kiss, did you ever imagine that the group would endure so long and through so many fads and trends, you know?
That's a tough one. I think at that point, when the first record was about to be recorded, the only thing we thought about was, God, let me just get one record out there so I can show my friends that, you know, I'm really somebody. It was a way to, you know, walk out of the streets and just become somebody. And I remember when the first album came out, I walked down 8th Street and 6th Avenue, place where we recorded the first album, walked into a store and bought my own record. I mean, that was a thrill of my life. And after that, it's been cream ever since, you know. Every record that comes out is still an unbelievable thrill. I mean, I don't want you to think that I'm just saying this stuff. Every album is just like, I can't believe it.
He calls me up and says I'm thrilled all the time.
So, no, I don't think anybody suspected it, but it's amazing. It just keeps going on and on. In fact, we just re-signed with Polygram, our label, for what amounts to almost 10 years of additional records. So I guess we'll see you at the end of eternity.
That's terrific.
Thanks for your call, Rick. Listening to 94.5 in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Luther, you're on with Gene and Paul from Kiss.
Hey, Gene. Hey, Paul.
Hey, guy.
I just want to know, what does the title Hot in the Shade mean?
Well, kind of, when we were doing the album, we were real excited about it. And, you know, there's a term sometimes people talk about, they say it's hot in the shade. When it's really, really hot, there's no getting away from the heat. It's something that's really undeniable. And we just felt so good about the album. It's like it's hot in the shade. You can't get away from the heat. It's just we're all fired up and having a great time.
All right. Alyssa knows exactly what you're talking about. She's calling in from New Orleans, that hot and humid city. B97 is the station she's listening to. Go ahead, Alyssa.
Yeah, what I was wondering was, are you guys ever going to do any more solo albums?
Probably not for a while. We have a piece of paper that says at some point in the next 10 years we're supposed to. The record company expects that stuff. But, you know, right now we're too busy having a good time making Kiss records. If we ever take some time off, a year or two, we may, but not for a while. Right now we're too busy getting geared up for that great Kiss 1990 Hot in the Shade tour.
All right. Thanks for the call tonight, Alyssa. Kiss is on Hitline. All right. Thanks for the call tonight, Alyssa. Kiss is on Hitline USA. I got it,
sad. I could lie to myself, but it's you.
Hitline USA. Now that's Kiss, their number one smash hit called Forever. Gene Simmons, Paul Stanley, thanks so much for coming. It was an honor talking to you tonight.
It was great.
All right, stand by. A turtle named Michelangelo is on hold direct from the sewer. He's up next.